Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. Today I will be discussing about Gayatri Mantra and why women should not chant this mantra. Why it is said in our Shastra so. For Hindus, the Gayatri Mantra is a very, very sacred mantra. And it is a Vedic mantra, or it appears in Rig Veda. It is actually, it appears in the 10th stanza of 62nd verse of 3rd mandala of Rig Veda. And this is believed to have been revealed by God himself to none other than Brahmarshi, the great Rishi Vishwamitra. Now, how Vishwamitra chants to get this mantra also is a very interesting story. I will tell it at some other point of time. Right now, I want to focus on this. But to mention it in one sentence, Vishwamitra, after he became Brahmarshi, he could project into the futuristic view, future. And he saw that a lot of people were going through pain and difficulties on this earth when he projected himself. So his good self started praying to God that please, you know, forgive all the people and reduce their karmas and, you know, let them ward off their difficulties. So this mantra was revealed to get protection from God, Almighty God. Now, this is actually to invoke a deity named Savitra. Therefore, this is also called as Savitri Mantra or Savitri Mantra also. Now, what does this word Savitra mean in Sanskrit? Savitra in Sanskrit means that which protects, that which heals, that which produces, that which generates, regenerates, rejuvenates. So it is mentioned, Savitri Kamanam Yadi Jagati Jagarti Bhavati. Okay. So now, actually, who is Savitra? Savitra is a son of Aditi. You all must be knowing about the stories how gods and demons were born and all. I'm not talking about the supreme gods. I mean, you know, remaining gods and all that. So there were two wives, like, you know, Aditi and Diti. Aditi's sons were called as Adityas. Diti's sons were called as Daityas. So Aditi is the one who gave birth to good children. Diti herself was a Rakshasi Kanya, or she was a demon princess who got married to a sage. All right. Now, he is a very important solar deity in Rig Veda. Therefore, he is also called as Aditya, one of the Adityas. Aditi's sons are Adityas. But he is not the sun, what we worship as a sun god separately. And he is in fact, you know, a kind of cousin to Surya. Or he is the first Aditya and then comes our sun god, that is Surya. Therefore, he is supposed to amplify the powers of Surya or the sun. So, Savitra is something, if you could imagine a sunrise, just before sunrise, a complete crimson color, comes on the sky. It is the spread of that color, that is Savitra. And then comes Surya. Now, Savitra has a very important mention in Rig Veda. His name appears 170 times throughout the text. And he is known to uphold and maintain dharma. And he is known to protect what is immovable and also that what is movable. It means charachara. In short, he is supposed to protect the entire life on this earth. So whether it is movable or immovable doesn't matter. Now, Savitra this Gayatri Mantra even has a mention in Bhagavad Gita. Lord Shri Krishna himself has told, I am Chando mein main Gayatri Chand hoon. Chanda is a meter, poetic meter. So he says in that verse, I am Gayatri. So that is the most superior mantra. That is what is believed. So every child is initiated into Upanayana or a thread ceremony in the Brahmini culture. And there a father is supposed to administer this mantra to mother. A father is supposed to initiate this to a child and mother is kept away. In fact, they cover the head, both father and the son cover their head, and then this mantra is, administered. Goddess Gayatri is a mother of all the Vedas, and she has, omnipresence. This mantra has omnipresence. But while chanting this mantra, one has to emphasize on the correct pronunciation. I keep on telling this every time. Otherwise, the consequences could be dangerous. See, all these Vedic mantras, they have a special purpose and they have a lot of potency. So, if you take a potent energy and then if you play with it, you know how harmful it can be. So, it is up to you how to harness and make that energy useful to you. So, all these syllables create a particular vibration in the body and then cosmic vibration. It's not just our body, because I'm chanting only, I will get in my body. So, sound is an energy. Ultimately, we are all particles of energy. If you look at the larger physics, if you go through quantum physics, so everything is around you is energy. You are energy. What you eat is energy. Everything in life is about energy. So, the energy spreads everywhere. So, it could be pretty dangerous. So, you need to be careful of the, and also there are a lot of restrictions. You should not chant it anytime and every time. And you have to, men chant it thrice a day after, early in the morning. And you have to be very careful and you have to do certain pranayama things and then pronounce. So that is called a Sandhya Vandana. So during which Gayatri is told. So anyway, this mantra is chanted with a pranava akshara, that is Omkara. So Om na Om, it begins with Om. Now let us see the important question, what I wanted to discuss. See, women were prohibited from chanting this holy mantra. It is not that, somebody wanted to sabotage women or establish, male dominance like that. There is a scientific reason behind it. Now, a lot of Westerners are researching on Gayatri mantra and the results are amazing. And we only, we have so much of wealth in our ancient India and whatever. But unfortunately, all of us are not completely understanding and trying to follow, or, even if we follow 5% of what we learn, our life will be totally different. So, according to Shastras, chanting of Gayatri mantra affects three chakras. Now, what are chakras? There are about 7 chakras in the body, and these are subtle energy centers. They are aligned, along with the spine at different places. So the first 3 chakras are the Muladhara chakra or root chakra, that is at the bottom of your tailbone. And then comes your, sacral chakra or Swadhisthana chakra, that is in the pelvic region. And then the third chakra is the Manipura chakra or Nabhi chakra, that is your navel, located in your navel. Navel is on the front side, but the chakras are along the spinal cord on the back side. So all these 3 are very important chakras, and this has got vibrations on all these 3 chakras. Now, chanting this mantra deeply also affects 2 major glands in the body, pituitary gland and prostate gland. And both these glands have effect on the gender growth. You can understand and gather information about this. So it is said that if women start chanting this mantra with all the faith and regularly at the regular time, women may even develop hormones of opposite gender, and they may see growth of facial hair on their face, facial hair like men, okay? And menstrual cycle will be imbalanced. And also, if a pregnant woman starts chanting this mantra, she may experience difficulties in breastfeeding. And also she may have difficulty in conceiving next time. So they may also experience muscular pain and bone, bone density may also go low. So, but during the Vedic times, you may be aware that even the prakriya of Upanayana, the samskara of Upanayana was administered to girls also. Before initiating them into education. But that was before puberty. Women are allowed to chant this, but before puberty, that is before they begin their menstruation, and after menopause. Okay, once they stop menstruating. It means during the reproductive cycle, this mantra should not be chanted. It has a scientific reason. And it is nothing, you know, to that male are superior, so they can chant and women no. But unfortunately, people do not understand the when certain restrictions are put or what you put, what is the thought process behind it and what could be the scientific reason behind it. Nobody bothers to check. These days, everybody, like, you know, they put this in on the, like, when you are going, passing through outside also, like, you know, on the roadside also, people put this Gayatri mantra on loudspeakers. People are putting it as their caller tune. I mean, this, it should not be done anytime, like, you know, like singing. It is not a song. It is a Rigveda mantra. So learn to respect what is given to us by our ancestors. And if you don't want to follow, don't follow. But if you want to follow, then follow it correctly is my humble request. Well, again, these are my views. You may agree or you may disagree. That is up to you. I'm not imposing, but I always love sharing my knowledge. And that's the reason I just wanted to tell you. Thank you so much. God bless.